There were times on Walton's Mountain so filled with peace and contentment that I might sit in my room writing and never once be reminded that I was part of a large and boisterous family.
Hey! Hey, John boy! I got a surprise for you!
Huh?
Guess who's here? Me!
You remember Hobie Shank?
Oh, get down here, old buddy! Me and you got some catching up to do!
Okay.
Little Hobie?
Big as life and twice as handsome. Just in time for my big surprise. And so are you, old buddy. Come on, I got a big surprise for y'all.
Surprise! Hi, I'm Mike McGreevy, also known as Hobart Shank, big as life and twice as handsome. It's been almost 40 years since I guest starred in that episode of the classic series, The Waltons. I later went on to write 4 episodes. And my father, John McGreevy, wrote over 20 episodes and earned himself an Emmy for his efforts. It was really the high point of my father's illustrious career. And I consider my Walton years as some of the most rewarding of my professional life. In 1971, a very talented writer who had already written several popular novels and numerous television shows and films decided that he wanted to tell a story from his real life experience. It concerned a Christmas Eve when his father was returning home late from work. Set in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia during the Depression, The Homecoming became a best-selling novel and then a very successful Christmas television special. It launched the Walton series, which ran for 9 years and is still being enjoyed by audiences all over the world. It all came about because of one man, Earl Hamner, a true Virginia gentleman and one of America's great storytellers. I'm honored to call him my friend and my mentor.
What was the surprise you were going to tell us about, Hobie?
Oh, sure. Well,
oh, right, Mr. Walton. I forgot. The surprise. We're producing a documentary about Earl. It's appropriately called Earl Hamner Storyteller. It includes interviews with writers, directors, actors, producers, fans, friends, and family, as well as featuring clips and scenes from all his films and television shows, and a special visit with Earl to his hometown of Schuyler, Virginia, in the Blue Ridge Mountains.
It was a nice story.
It was a beautiful story. It was the beginning of many good stories. And again, I think it was generated from these roots here.
This building we're in was once a hospital, but today it's a private residence. It's very special to me because 90 years ago, I was born here.
But most importantly, we interviewed Earl and got his story from the master storyteller himself. So here's the pitch.
Might not be able to pitch him there, but you sure could talk it there.
Give me a break, Grandpa. I'm doing the best I can. So here's the pitch. Why an Indiegogo campaign? Well, as most of you already know, it's very expensive to film any film, but in particular, a film like Earl Hamner, Storyteller. In order to tell Earl's story effectively, we need to show his work, and that costs a lot. All the clips we use have to be purchased, and we have to pay the actors, the writers, the directors their fair share too. When you're dealing with a body of work as huge as Earl's, the license fees add up real fast. The rest of the production has been done on a minimal budget, with most of us volunteering our time to produce this project about a man we love and respect. But now we need your help to complete the production. We want you to join us and become part of our team by pledging what you can. Our goal is $125,000. Please donate anything you can afford.
The slightest idea what you're talking about.
I'll explain it to you later.
Grandma, it's real simple. We need money, but for a great cause. To tell the story of a man who has entertained and enlightened people all around the world for over 70 years. We need each and every one of you out there to donate what you can.
That includes you too, John Boy.
See? Even John Boy's on board.
Night, boys. Night, everybody.